A lot of the problems we solved. There are a few things which can be expected or can be predicted to be quite sure. Yeah. One thing is very clear for us, and everyone knows that. Everyone can read that in, don't know, Wikipedia or wherever. Yeah. We will have more people on Earth. Yeah. Within the next people in 15 years, the number of people living in the, at least in the, on Earth will rise up to 8.5 billion people. Yeah. From now, 7.3 billion people. And then, of course, we can look a little bit more in detail. From where will the growth come from? Yeah, what will be at least the big group of getting to this number of people growth? And then we see, according to a prediction of OECD, we very clear it is at least some kind of a middle class group which will grow worldwide. Yeah, and as today, middle class group is around about 24% of the global population. Yeah? We have even a further more growth than total population. And in 2030, we expect that middle class will be 4.9 billion people, or 58, more than 50% of the people living on Earth will live in at least in some kind of a middle class lifestyle situation. So the growth is at least even also some kind of welfare growth, some kind of at least economy growth, which can be predicted even also with this growth of at least middle class people. And we have seen this in a short clip even this morning. Yeah, if we then have a look, where do these middle class grow? Yeah, then we, at least it's a growing up in Asia what happens. Yeah. Asia, 28 of the middle class today is living in Asia, but if we go furthermore, yeah, to the year 2020, this share of middle class in Asia living is 54%. And if we go even again furthermore, 10 years, we see two-thirds of the middle class population on world will live in Asia. And I think even this is even also a very good reason and an important reason, yeah, to move or to get at least even started CE China as well. Yeah, as at least a lot of this technical development, a lot of technical demand, a lot of technical sales at least will happen, of course, in Asia in the future. Another trend, which is very clearly to understand, is at least what we call urbanization. Yeah? Today, 50% of the global people are living in cities, in urban areas. Yeah? This will rise up until the year 2030 to two-thirds of the population. Two-thirds of the population in the future will live at least in urban areas. And with the challenge, I think we should go even also in detail, what does this mean for cities? Yeah? Tokyo will remain as a big mega city, close to 40 million people. But if we see up, Delhi, yeah, will grow up within the next 15 years by around plus 11 million people, in addition, living to these already 25 million people living nowadays in Delhi. Yeah, if we have a look to Shanghai at least, even also Shanghai will grow up by another 8 million. Yeah, so the big, big mega cities, and especially the big mega cities in Asia, will grow within the next 15 years for sure. And we have another trend. I think most of us is aware of that at the time. Yeah, we will have a growth of single-person households. A growth of single-person households growing up by plus 40% until the year 2030. Yeah, we have a trend that in one country, Sweden, yeah, in Sweden already 46% of the households are single-person households. Yeah, in Germany we are above 40% meanwhile, but it's not only growing in Europe or in North America. This is something which happens at least even also in China, or will happen in Asia as well, which happens all around the world. This is not that young people at the time we are at least we not willing to get married or not willing to have a family. Yeah, this is at least even also has to do with mobility. Yeah, that couples are separated. Yeah, husband is living in one city. Yeah, but his wife and maybe the children is living in another city. Yeah, then we have two households, and one of that is for sure a single person household. Yeah, so we have a development which rise up and which is even also a social challenge in the future, that the number of single person households will grow up by plus 40% within the next 15 years. And then the question is, of course, this is the development of population. Yeah, it is a forecast, yes, of course, but will this demographic change at least even also boost demand? I will take out for this at least one example, which is at least involving every one of us. Yeah, this is the development of the smartphone. And please remember back, yeah, the first Apple smartphone, yeah, came up in the market in 2006. It's a technology which is existing since 10 years only. Yeah, we try now at least a prediction for the next 15 years. But it was not 15 years ago. 15 years ago, there have been maybe a mobile phone existing in the market, but not the smartphone. We do not know, of course, what kind of technology will come up. But within the next few minutes, we will pick up at least what is existing and what can we expect at least in these products being connected at least to the smartphone. Yeah, and this 1.4 billion smartphones to be sold in 2016 as an expectation. Yeah, the growth is coming from emerging Asia Pacific. We see emerging Asia Pacific will grow up by plus 22%. Even also Middle East and Africa will grow up by plus 16%. However, the biggest market for smartphones is the Chinese market. Still growing by plus 3%, China is 28% in sales of smartphones. 28%. By population, China is even the biggest country, but it's 18%. Yeah, so at least number of smartphones sold in China is much bigger compared around the world. Emerging Asia will grow by plus 22%. There we have India, of course, but it's not only the growth of India, it's at least even also the growing countries in Southeast Asia, Malaysia, Indonesia, Philippines, Vietnam, all these with a huge demand, at least in the smartphone market. If you take Europe, and if you take together Central and Eastern Europe and Western Europe, we come up to 16%, which is, as to be pointed to be out, with a bigger market than North America, which is 14%. And even we have a lot of interstate conflict in Europe. If you take Russia and Ukraine, yeah, we see that the market in Europe, in total, if you take Western and Eastern Europe together, will grow by more than plus 4%. Yeah, even also, the growth rate for smartphones in Europe is bigger than the growth rate in North America. And on a global level, the market will grow by plus 7% in 2016. So, we have a world of smartphones, consumers own these smartphones, getting connected, and what will they ask for? Let's take a few examples. Yeah. We have to understand that it is at least not only to having a new gadget with your smartphone. Oh, fantastic, I have a smartphone, I have a look here, this is the latest technology on smartphones. There will be at least much more I think what the functionality will at least at the end be the push for this smartphone market. Yeah, it will not only be a connectivity. Yeah, connectivity will be integrated. Yeah, it is not only one to one. This is now connected to my smartphone. Yeah, but at least the whole environment around you will be connected. We speak about some kind of integrated connectivity we have to expect in the future. Yeah? Integrated connectivity is something we are faced when we go shopping. Yeah? And if we take shoppers, Schroppers report that they have at the end, if we take Asia Pacific, 46% of the shoppers told us within the last 6 months they have done either online sales with their smartphone or even have paid with their smartphone. The smartphone became the wallet, we at least even also. Yeah, they use their smartphone either to order a product, which might even happen in the shop. Yeah, even they go to a retailer, step in, having a look to the product, yeah, see the product they want to have is not available, and then they order this by smartphone. They order this by smartphone and get it paid at least even also with the smartphone. Or they use their smartphone at least even as a wallet, put it down at least on the device and get paid. Yeah, which is more and more popular at least in China. I remember quite well when I came for the first time to China, which was around about 10 years ago. I was astonished going into shops as Suning or Gourmet, people bought a TV set and counted thousands of yuan in their hand at least to get this TV set to be paid. Yeah? And meanwhile, they get this more and more often done at least even also with their smartphone. Yeah? And Asia is far above the level of payments and going shopping with a smartphone is far above what we see in Europe, even what we see in the United States. So this becomes some kind of new convenience. Yeah? It is at least your smartphone controlled at least even by your face. Yeah? This is your wallet, which means at the end your face is getting your wallet. Yeah? You are paying with something very, very, very confidential and very, very, very personal, with a very personal device to go at least to be shopping. And if we ask consumers in a big global survey in a lot of countries, at least in 14 countries all around the world, people are aware that this is convenience. Yeah? Paying with the smartphone makes the payment at least much faster. Yeah? It's some very convenience. Yeah, it's more efficient, it's easier than other payment methods. Yeah. But we see all these ratios are 33% or beyond. Yeah. So it's not above 50%. Yeah. We see there is still room at least to explain that technology. There is still a need at least for communication to get this at least either done or to get this improved even also in the future. We take the connected consumer, we have seen they get aware that payment is possible, but if we take this connected consumer and we ask at least within the next future what will be the attitudes to be like, and then we have a lot of things which is at least very important for these consumers. One is entertainment. Entertainment and at least even also music. Yeah? And with the smartphone, much more than with the MP3 player maybe 5 years ago or 10 years ago. Yeah, they are aware they have their music, their own music, the music they enjoy, the music they like most, at least we are all around them. They have their music always and everywhere. Yeah, and we see headphone market is booming at the moment. Yeah, headphone market is coming up to 334 million headphones, headsets, which will be sold in 2016. And wireless technology is, of course, in addition coming up. Yeah, consumers are not interested, at least, in having a headphone around them by walking through the living room to the kitchen and then back to the bedroom, always with a headset or with a headphone around them. Yeah, so they get docking speakers, Bluetooth docking speakers. Yeah, great solution we get from the industry at the moment to have at least some kind of multi-room audio equipment at home, moving with your smartphone from one room to another and having all your most favorite music be available all around in your house. Another attitude is for sure express yourself. Yeah. Yeah, smartphone market means at least even also a device where a camera is built in, is booming. Yeah. Even I have no figures on that now here with me, but we are auditing this as well. Yeah. Selfie stick market is booming at the moment. Yeah, and even here I saw these selfie sticks. This is something, at least in Wieso, which has to do with this attitude to be express yourself. Yeah, action cams. Yeah, an action cam is at least in Wieso a product. Yeah, which young people, and my son even has also made one of these action cams. And so, hey, I go skiing and I will have at least Wieso, I will show my friends what I have done in winter by going skiing. Yeah, and they put this in on YouTube and they have this in they share this in of course. It is express your leg, yourself. Yeah. And a lot of software is at least really supporting this. Instagram is one, Flickr is one of course, where you can show at least what you have done, where you are, how you look at least to me too, all around the world at the end. And we have a new development in smartwatches. Yeah, we expect in 2016, 38 million smartwatches to be sold, in 2017, even close to 75 million smartwatches to be sold. Yeah, a smartwatch is not at least having another watch than what we have in a traditional way. A smartwatch is much more than having at least only a fitness tracker. Yeah, it is at least the most important group or the most important product among all these variables. Yeah. And it is again that at least having a look to your smartphone is much easier at least than with a smartwatch. Yeah. Messages coming in, email is coming in, but people expect at least more with their smartwatch. Yeah. Yeah. By a study, by questionnaire we have done, we saw 49% of the people we are interested at least even also, can I get the smartphone connected to my smart home? Yeah, that I, at least even having a look to my smartwatch, I can see is the door closed or not, is the garage closed or not, or is at least the light switched off or on. Yeah. Can I control my car with a smartwatch?
Yes.
Yeah, coming close to my car, yeah, by fingertip I open my car. Yeah. Why do I need a second key at least before my car? Yeah. So a lot of things around these consumers are at the end to be connected with their smartwatch and then connected at least even also to the smartphone. Yeah? But it should be easy. 90% expect at least to be the software, yeah, or how to use it at least should be similar, the smartwatch and the smartphone. Yeah? And coming at least even also to a more software-related development, this is with Facebook. Yeah, we cannot ask the question anymore, is Facebook in or is Facebook out? Are you on Facebook or are you not on Facebook? Will this rise up or will this not rise up? Will this be at least a bit of positive development or negative development? Facebook just is. Yeah, 1.6 billion people are registered all around the world on Facebook. Not everyone might use this every day, yeah. But at least it's 47% of the people, yeah, who are internet users have at least even also an account on Facebook, yeah. A tremendous development over the last years, and it's at least even also something which is existing since a couple of years, not since 5 years, since 10 years or 15 years, yeah. It's something which came up at least very new. Yeah. And we have to understand smartphone is not anymore a device for pure communication. Yeah. 47% of the teens worldwide say it is important to be reachable wherever they are. But this went down, yeah, over the last 6 years by 20 percent points. Yeah. So means in 2009, 2010, it was important for the people, especially for the young people, oh yes, you can call me everywhere, whenever you like, please call me, give me a call. Yeah. Now they say, this is reduced now. Yeah. They do not want to be reachable everywhere and every time. Even not my children, I have to understand, want to get a phone call from the father wherever they are or whenever they are, at least to be out of home. Yeah, so it is the importance of the smartphone is less the communication device than at least the device of doing a lot of other things, of controlling the smart home, yeah, of getting your music everywhere and all around you, yeah, having a lot of new things, yeah, and not a development into having a better communication or being reachable, at least in the all around the world, wherever you are or whenever you are moving. Yeah. What is next coming up? Yeah. We are starting with very tiny markets in a lot of areas, but for sure what is coming up is at least connectivity and integrated connectivity will impact our daily life. I do not want to discuss in sentences and minutes and hours this Internet of Things, which is, yes, it is existing, it will boost the demand or whatever it is. Yeah? Internet of Things is already existing. Internet of Things is at least when you at home have a printer in your studio, yeah, but you print out at least something from your tablet or from your PC, which is at least in a complete other room. Yeah, so experience of Internet of Things we have since several years. But it will come up into a lot of new things, not only in office equipment, not only at least in this IT equipment. Yeah? It will come up in small domestic appliances with the healthcare. Yeah? That at least we're going to be at least with the blood pressure measurement, having at least be not only on your smartphone, but can be sent at least immediately to your doctor. Yeah? Connected audio we have seen. Yeah? Virtual reality. Yeah? We have this new glasses which are coming up, which are at least only coming up as they are linked to the smartphone. We have new video consumption I will show later on, with the wearables and the smart watches, we have mobile payment, we have smart home, we will have connected cars and start up with the connected cars. And for sure, for a company as Tesla, yes, Internet of Things is existing. Yeah, this is at least the strategy of e-mobility we have at the moment. Drones are coming up, 3D printing is coming up. Everything at least at the end, yeah, possible or pushed up by the development of smartphone technology. Yeah. And when we pick up a few examples of this, yeah, pick up the smart home for example. Yeah. 9 out of 10 people meanwhile are aware, yes, smart home is existing. Yeah, and if we go in detail, 50% of the consumer fear that their smart home will impact their life in the upcoming years. Yeah, so if we have done this studies 2 years ago, yeah, and we have done this 2 years ago, a lot of people said to me, smart home, oh, no, sorry, never heard about that. Meanwhile, with smart home, 90% of the people know smart home is existing. And this is not in one country. This is, again, at least a global survey we have done, yeah, in Asia, in America, in Europe as well. Yeah? And smart home is something which, at the end, even also is important for major domestic appliances. Yeah? My colleague, Friedemann Stöckle, this morning, showed me, at least in his speech, this development on major domestic appliances. Yeah, even if we calculate the development of this market in value, in dollar, it goes down by -7%, but this says nothing. Yeah, at least this is something which is the dollar going up or going down. This is currency exchange ratio, yeah, which is changing. Yeah, in units, global, the market is going up maybe by +1%, and it will go up even also in the year 2016. If we recalculate this in Euro 2015, the market grew up by +11% in value. Yeah, so smart home is something which will get more and more important, at least even also on the major domestic appliances market. Yeah, we get this connectivity at least even also important for the small domestic appliances market. And small domestic appliances, again, in terms of value, calculated in dollar, the market went down. Yeah? But in units, we saw this morning, it's a positive development in the market by a lot of new innovative products. Yeah? And not only this vacuum cleaner robot, yeah? But especially in healthcare development, we saw a lot of new products which are coming up. Yeah, even Bluetooth teeth brushes. I've bought even also one for my family. And my son was astonished that I can control now that this hasn't been 2 minutes. I saw this on the toothbrush, this has been less than 2 minutes. Hey, how do you know? I see this on this at least smart device now. Yeah? And smart home is at least even also smart entertainment. Smart entertainment at home. Yeah? And we have still an ongoing, not interrupted in sales, at least the development in the TV market. Close to 240 million TV sets will be expected to be sold in 2018. Yeah, it is at least a rather stable curve. 2016 slightly negative, coming up again in 2018, the LCD TV market. Yeah, and OLED is coming in addition to that market. But the big change in this market happens to be at least on one hand with a better picture quality. Yeah, we see step by step a growth in 4K. Yeah, 4K UHD was something people ask for and will buy and is growing, and the growth is coming from China, we have to understand. And we have a growth in smart TV, and I think this is something which is very important. TV is even now also be connected. Yeah, TV is connected, yeah, and this is important as TV, videos, movies, yeah, this is emotion. Yeah, this is emotion, and we know in those countries where we are auditing even also the visit to cinemas. Yeah, cinema is a stable point in the world, especially of the young people. Yeah, consumer continuously and ongoing visit the cinema, getting this big experience of a big screen, and have still continuously, of course, this basic wish, I want to have this cinema feeling, this emotional cinema feeling, even also we at home market in TV is especially growing by big screen sizes. By screen sizes, even also with 10 years ago, consumer had never had in mind that they will have a 65-inch screen size at home. Yeah, 10 years ago it was mostly a 32-inch screen size they have had. Yeah, TV is changing. Yeah, it is first of all on a high level. Yeah, the broadcasted, the traditional broadcasted TV. Yeah, which is, if we make a forecast to 2007, we expect a minus 2% only. It is still approximately 3 hours a day. Yeah, the traditional TV program is broadcasted to your home, and at least we switched on your TV set. This is the first step why you need the TV set and why people use the TV set. And then we have, in addition, a change with this internet connectivity. Yeah. Yeah, and the internet media consumption will grow up by plus 18% to be until the year 2017. So it is not automatically, of course, even also in the future, that your movie is coming from your satellite dish on the roof. Yeah, more and more it will come at least to be from the internet to the connection. Yeah. We know Netflix, we know Amazon Fire, we know in China, of course, the huge success of LED TV, yeah, which has been able, at least, yeah, as these TV sets are connected to the internet, the content is coming from the internet. Yeah. This is a globalization which happens at the moment on TV. Yeah. Not only having bigger screens and not only having a better picture quality, but having access at least to, in Europe, to American series. Yeah. Having, when I watch, at least when I'm in Asia, yeah, the latest crime movie of last Sunday, which has happened in Germany. Yeah. This is something which is at least even also getting people more closer together, having access to the same content. Yeah, and we have YouTube, of course, and then YouTube not only will at least available on a small screen, yeah, on your mobile device, we have YouTube available at least even also on your screen in the living room on your big screen size. Yeah, 300 hours of video are uploaded every minute to be on YouTube. There are 1 billion mobile YouTube videos viewed per day. YouTube is at least even also which is entertainment, which came up in a very, very short time, and which has a huge impact at least on our life. Coming to the end, at least, of what are our expectations, what are the key findings, the key takeaways, at least, of the market development we have at the moment and we expect at least even also for the next upcoming years. First is the connected consumer is evolving at least from some kind of connectivity to some kind of integrated connectivity. It is not that benefit one-to-one and another benefit there one-to-one. He has some kind of integrated connected world, which includes the home, which includes maybe the car in the future as well, which includes entertainment on video or on music, which includes health, your health technology, whatever you have around. Yeah? This is integrated in connectivity. The next one is at least the digital world, yeah, which is again, if we calculate this, and I must bring this figure as well, as we are at least calculating everything in development, we 2016 an expectation of -4% in US dollar. But this includes at least the expectation even also what happens with currency exchange rates. The market is stable at least if you take this unit wise, yeah. We have a big boom of +7% we have seen on smartphones. Yeah. We have on the other hand, by picking up this chance of smartphones and by picking up at least even also the smart TV, that other technologies are falling down. Yeah. People do not buy an MP3 player anymore as they have a smartphone. People do not buy or less and less often buy a DVD player as they get their content at least via the internet. Yeah. So market is in terms of the unit development, digital world unit based development is stable, yeah, and is moving at least as some kind of vital market at least to new technologies, yeah, and fading out technologies we have as well. People will spend in the future, at least even not only money buying a new gadget, buying a new device. People will spend money at least even also for, at the end it's software, for solutions. Yeah? Netflix is one solution. Yeah? YouTube or other things is at least even also a solution. Yeah? There will be solutions on smartphones, there will be solutions at least even also on healthcare programs, there will be solutions from insurance companies or whatever it is. Yeah, so it is a complete new world which is coming up, which has nothing to do at least only with devices, yeah, but the benefits is coming at least from software. And this is something which is especially picked up at the moment even also by major domestic appliances and small domestic appliances. Yeah. Major domestic appliances is a market which will grow up at least by picking up the chance of smart home and smart products. Small domestic appliances will pick this up as well. Yeah? The connectivity, the integrated connectivity, yeah, will impact our whole life, and consumers are aware of that this integrated connectivity will impact our whole life. Yeah? Doesn't matter whether it's home domestic appliances, it's domestic appliances, whether it's small domestic appliances, doesn't matter whether it's at least your mobility, doesn't matter whether it's your entertainment development, whatever it is. Internet of Things is already existing. We have to think now that we at least, and at the end, the future is now. Thank you very much.